wonderful to see all of your smiling faces this morning. Our choir has been working very hard the last few months to bring you some music and scripture celebrating this joyous Christmas season. Would you please join me in our call to worship? Give ear, O Shepherd of Israel, you who lead Joseph like a flock. Restore us, O God. Let your face shine that we may be saved. Then we will never turn back from you. Give us life and we will call on your name. Restore us, O Lord of hosts. Let your face shine that we may be saved. Let us worship God, shall we pray. Your face is shown upon us, O God, in the young woman who is with child. She will bear a son and name him Emmanuel, God with us. Your presence shall hereafter be a source of comfort and guidance to all that call on your name. Your footsteps shall accompany us. Your breath shall give us new life. Your arms will console us, and your hands will be there to welcome us home. You're a God for all seasons and give us all reason to worship your name. Amen. Shall we join in our first carol, number 277? Remain standing as we share in our Advent candle lighting this morning with the Kenzer family. And I'm thinking that maybe they're not up here. All right.
They might be in the kitchen.
Ginger, come forward, sister.
With your daughter.
Will you come and light the candles while I read? Yes. Embarrassment. Last Sunday, we lit the candle of hope, remembering the hope which comes in Christ, the candle of peace, remembering God's dream of a peaceful world, and the candle of joy, remembering the Spirit within us who brings joy. All of them. Oh.
always that moment. Is there enough wick?
Oh my goodness.
Yes, good save it.
Fix that problem. Yep. Today we are lighting the fourth candle of Advent, and it's the candle of love. Oh, poor Ginger. I really put her on the spot today.
She's a little warning.
Yeah.
She's short on top of it, so.
Yeah.
There we go.
She's going to have fun with it.
To the right a little.
Yeah. So today we are lighting the fourth candle of love, and our scripture tells us, there is no fear in love, for perfect love casts out fear, found in 1 John chapter 4, verse 18. God created this world in love, and this world will end in the love of God. God's love pervades all aspects of this life, from birth to death, pain to delight, strangers to lovers. God's love is there. Today we light this candle in love. On this day, we remember God is love. I think you got it.
Yep, it's lit.
Yep, it's lit. Yeah, here. Thank you. Oh, you need this. When you're the redheaded sister from another mister, you get lots of jobs you don't expect. Shall we join together in our prayer of confession? You shower gifts on your people, O God, and forgive their faults. We keep accounts and settle old scores. You make peace, sending Christ as a sign of reconciliation and hope. We make war and call it peacekeeping. You give us a source of confidence as your Spirit is sent into our midst. We cause others to be relentless in our anxiety and self-concern. Have mercy upon us, forgive and free us, that we may be renewed to serve your people with goodwill. Hear our assurance of pardon. The Most High is called merciful because God has mercy on those who have not yet come into the world, and gracious because God is rich in grace to those who repent and turn to the law, and compassionate because God makes compassion abound more and more within all of creation. Live in this knowledge and be confident that your sins are forgiven. Of God be with you.
And also with you.
Greet one another with a hug and a little peace to go with it.
Very hard.
Oh,
very hard. Good morning. We'd like to invite the children who are here today to come forward for a time together. Come on up. Good morning. Come on up, Natalie. Good morning. I want to thank both of you and all your friends for doing our children's program last week. And this week, the choir is going to do their program. And in our programs, we have told the story of the birth of Jesus Christ. And it's a really exciting story. So today I'm going to share with you another version of the story of Jesus. It's a little booklet that I have. And it's called When Jesus Was Born. And I know you guys know this story, but this is another way of telling it. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem, with the sun gone to sleep in the west, stars may have shone, but few could have known on this night God would give us his best. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem, God's ancient promise came true. A baby so dear, with animals so near, a savior for me and for you. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem, some shepherds kept sheep safe from danger. Did they know? Would they guess that this night God would bless all the world through a gift in a manger? When Jesus was born in Bethlehem, night's darkness cracked open with light. When into the sky, angels burst from on high, singing praises with joy. What a sight! Just picture it. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem, the angels gave shepherds a clue. The message still sounding, with hearts and feet pounding, shepherds hurried to find Jesus too. Sounds a lot like our story last week. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem, God's ancient promise came true. Though born in a stall, he was king over all. Jesus came to save me and you. And today, while we're listening to the adults tell us their Christmas story, I want you to listen. Listen for the story of the shepherd. Listen for the birth of the baby. Listen, because they're going to tell us the same story that I just read and the same story that we told, but they're going to tell it in a different way. So I want to encourage you to sit and listen to the words. They're very beautiful, and they're words you know. Let us pray. God, at this special time of year, we come together and once again celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Help us to remember to keep him at the center of all we do, and may our hearts be filled with love, with giving, and with joy. In your name we pray. Amen. All right, go back, sit with your folks, and we're going to enjoy the Christmas story.
Rock!
the miracle of Christmas, the greatest miracle of all, when God sent his son into our world as a tiny baby. There were few who expected his coming that night in Bethlehem, though devout Jews had been praying for the Messiah for centuries. In fact, God had promised a redeemer to Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. In the years that followed, he repeated his promise over and over again through prophets and priests. Christ's birth in Bethlehem was the fulfillment of all that had been prophesied. And the time came for Jesus to step into history through Jesus Christ, his Son. Christmas began when God sent his angel to a young girl whose name was Mary. He announced that God had chosen her for the most holy event in human history. She was to be the mother of the Son of God.
Treasure to me, Lord, fill me.
Joseph, Mary's husband-to-be, these events were beyond comprehension. But he committed himself to obey what God had clearly told him. Bethlehem was very crowded that night, and Joseph could find no place to stay. The innkeeper took pity on the couple when he saw Mary's condition and put them up for the night in the stable. It was there that the Lord Jesus was born, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, born in a manger.
Lord,
from Bethlehem. Some shepherds were taking care of their sheep that night, when suddenly an angel of the Lord appeared and announced the birth of the Savior. After their initial shock, the shepherds decided to go at once and see for themselves the miracle of that first Christmas.
Out on the hills, not too far from the town, shepherds were watching their sheep on that night. Suddenly there in the skies was a sound, and fear gripped them all at the sight.
Don't be afraid, said the angels to them. Good news I bring both to you and all men. This very night there
shepherds came and worshipped the infant Son of God, Mary pondered all these things in her heart. It was so wonderful seeing the sovereign purposes of God unfold before her. Her heart was filled with gratitude and praise. The shepherds heard the angelic announcement, but far away in a distant land, the wise men saw an unusual star in the sky. For them, it signaled the birth of one who would be king of the Jews, and they followed the star until they found the newborn Messiah in Bethlehem.
Thank you.
The miracle of Christmas was that God would appear in human flesh, live amongst us, and ultimately die on the cross so that our sins could be forgiven. The scriptures sum it up in perhaps the best known of all verses. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life.
Father, who sent the Savior down to the earth.
And say what we believe found in our bulletin, the affirmation of faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended to hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended to heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated. Yes, we have two great joys today. We had that great gift that the choir gave us, hearing about the wonderful good news of Jesus Christ in song. And we also have a wonderful meal downstairs. Some individuals have been working really hard. It's a nice breakfast downstairs. So please come downstairs and eat with us. A couple of announcements. This Saturday night at 7 o'clock will be our Christmas Eve service, 7 o'clock this Saturday. Since Christmas Eve is falling on Saturday at session, we decided that we wouldn't have a service on that Sunday morning, so next Sunday morning we will not have a worship service. The last time we did it, we had like six people show up, so we decided we would try not having one, see what happened.
Six people and the choir.
What?
Six people and the choir.
Yes. Yes. Six people in choir. So Christmas Eve, 7 o'clock on Saturday. Any other announcements that anyone has? Yes.
I would like you to keep the David Knowles family.
He passed away.
He passed away.
Yeah, David Knowles passed away, so keep his family.
Sandy Borg's family, too.
Sandy Borg's. Anyone else? And let us together as God's people in prayer, let us pray. Lord God, we are so thankful as a people that you have given so many gifts to us. You've given us the gift of music and song so that we may know you better, so we may understand your love and your mercy and forgiveness at a greater depth. We thank you, Lord God, for these gifts, and we thank you for the individuals who have volunteered their time and energy and effort to help serve you this day and to sing to your glories. We pray, Lord God, that you'll bless all of us in this coming weeks as we seek to be true to the call that you have given us in coming into the world and claiming us as men and women and children of faith in this world, asking us to show the world that you live by our love, by our faith, and by our kindness. We pray, Lord God, that your Spirit will be upon each and every one of us so that we may be witnesses to the good news that you were born in this world so long ago, born to save us, born to give us things that are difficult to even imagine. We also pray this day, Lord God, for all of the churches in our community around the world as they are preparing to spread the good news of your birth. We pray, Lord God, especially for those individuals who are in situations where they are going through great persecution and struggles and difficulties and pains in the midst of this season. We pray that you'll be with them and your Spirit will enable the good news to spread. We also pray this day, Lord God, for all across the world, remembering that you came to one day institute a world of peace. We remember so many of the places in our world and our community where there is a lack of peace, so much suffering and pain. We pray, Lord God, that you'll be with these individuals in a very special way. We also pray in particular, God, for the families of Sandy and David as they're going through their grief. And now let us take a few moments to pray for those we're concerned about. Lord, we thank you for hearing our prayers for others. And now let us pray the prayer our Lord and Savior taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Please join me in the prayer of dedication. The stage is set for the presentation of your gift of life, O Christ, and we are part of the company of players. As the curtain is about to rise, we prepare ourselves for our roles. We commit what we have to the drama that enlivens lives. Help us to step onto the stage with anticipation and boldness. May we know the script so well that we shall not falter as we share your gift in us. Amen.
Thank you.